I have to get back. Of course. He moved to one side to let me get past, and the scent bubbled up behind his words. I'd never be able to hear anyone say, of course, again, without the memory of that outdoorsy sort of smell coming back to haunt me. Just thought I'd give you a quick heads up, Lydia. We'll start work on it next week. Maybe during English? A proper read-through and casting and everything? And I want you to notice that I'm still being civil and polite here, although every line of your body seems to say that you want to hit me. I had to smile at that. I wouldn't hit you. Pelt me with whiteboard markers, then. He gave what might have been a small grin. I don't not like you, I said it quietly. I just think we should be professional. Because we work together, it doesn't mean we have to be plaiting one another's hair and comparing fingerlings. The grin got just the tiniest bit wider. You really do need to mix more with people over the age of 9. And anyway, that's not really true, is it? You're friends with Irina, and you're wonderful to the kids, and they're your job. In fact, you love the kids. I've seen you with them, remember? Children are different. There was a moment of silence. Well, as near to silence as one can ever get in a school. There were the usual distant, raised voices, the whine of the photocopier, the outside hum of a hedge trimmer. In the office, just Jake and me. It was quiet. I picked up the cast list again, and between my fingers the pages crackled. It was a situation that begged one of us to speak, but neither of us did. And I squeezed past him, and his outdoor smell, and his sportsman frame.